Hi all, welcome to Powershell for Penetration Testers at Pentester Academy. From this video, let's start a series of videos on interacting with .NET using PowerShell. In some upcoming videos, we will see how .NET classes and assemblies could be used to extend the reach and power of PowerShell. We will not only use the built-in assemblies, we will also write some interesting code to solve some problems. In this video, let's have a look at exploring .NET classes with PowerShell. We will see how to explore assemblies, listing public types, listing classes we want or assemblies we want, and using them. I have copied the commands here so that you could use them later on. So let's use app domain . This lists the currently loaded assemblies in PowerShell session. Now, since we are trying to stick with PowerShell version 2 as much as we can, let's use for each object If it was to be run on PowerShell version 3, we could have simply used dot get types here instead of running this on each object. So it's a really long list, but we are interested mostly in the classes where is public is true. So let's specify that. So we have a long list of classes and assemblies with is public true. That is, they could be used. So this is the way to explore .NET classes in PowerShell. But there is nothing really useful yet. Let's save this output in a variable called classes. Now to look for classes, let's take an example. We frequently used the get process commandlet. Let's use a PowerShell, a .NET class to list processes on this machine. So again, where object to the rescue. Let's search for class whose name equals process. Note that we should use match or contains here if we do not know the exact name. Sorry. As you can see that a class object has been returned. Let's store it in a variable called proc class. Now recall that we have been using a commandlet quite frequently, the get member. Get member is used to list methods and properties of an object. So let's list all the members, which is a really long list, list only functions or methods, again a long list. Get member does not return the static members by default. For that we need to pass the static as well as intrinsic members. Both are not returned. Let specifically ask for static methods. As you can see that there are some really interesting methods: get current process, get process by ID, get processes. That means our proc class object could be used to call static methods. Notice the way we have used the static member, and this is the output. Another interesting way is you can use the type name and we can also get it by this method. You will see this in many PowerShell scripts. We can now use the methods. For example, we can use get processes, etc. Also, here we can use some things we saw earlier, like this, to get much more details. So this was a quick example of using the .NET classes or assemblies. So that is all for this video. If you are enjoying your time at Pentester Academy, please recommend us to your friends and colleagues in the information security community.